United States Army Air Force is off for Berlin. Bucking a 70-mile-an-hour headwind, our flying forts hit temperatures ranging as low as 58 below zero as it bombs away over the German capital. Motors is shot out as we head for home after this big raid that cost us 14 bombers. That channel is a welcome sight. Air Force pictures show how flares are used to signal which forts have wounded crewmen aboard and to send medical ground crews into action. They'll be ready with first aid and blood plasma. First American flag to fly over Berlin. Heroes of the 8th Air Force, they tell of their first daylight raid.
I'd like to introduce the pilot of the crew on this lead ship, Lieutenant Brown. Brownie?
Colonel, I was glad that I was along with him. I don't care about too many of them like that.
Fine. Sergeant, you were flying as waist gunner in the sack robbers.
Well, Colonel, all I got to say is my birthday that day, and it was a hell of a place to celebrate a birthday, but it was well worth it to be the first one to go over to Berlin.
Well, boys, how would you like to go over again?
German prisoners of war in a northern Michigan camp take to their daily chores with a will, as the Signal Corps pictures show. Use of the men for timber work was recently authorized to offset the grave labor shortage. Many of these men are expert shoemakers. Prisoners receive 80 cents a day. They may save it or spend it at the prison canteen. Meals equivalent to those of the Army are served and apparently enjoyed. There is no boredom here. This is imprisonment in humane America. Brazilian fishermen find good fishing off their coast that pays better returns than the finny variety. The catch is crude rubber, lost by the German war machine when the U.S. Navy sank three blockade runners. The German ships were bound from the Dutch East Indies with their vital cargoes when caught and sunk. Since then, fishermen have salvaged from 10 to 20 tons a day. Hitler's loss will help keep our war machines rolling. At an airport somewhere in the Caribbean, a huge U.S. transport brings in Eleanor Roosevelt. Signal Corps pictures show her stopping off here on one of her many trips. The Caribbean is important in America's defensive pattern, and Mrs. Roosevelt, with General Shedd, reviews the troops that are the bulwark of our far-flung defenses to the south. A new Australian destroyer is being christened today by Mrs. Douglas MacArthur. Named the Bataan in tribute to these gallant men of General MacArthur's who fought the Japs to the very end, she will bear an honored name.
Listen, the Bataan, and may God bless you.
Bataan is a name that this proud ship goes forth to avenge. May she have the honor of sailing victoriously past Bataan itself in our sweep to victory. A task force raids the Saipan Tinian Islands in the Marianas Group. Jap planes attack. Twenty-nine Japs shot from the sky. Altogether, including those wrecked on the ground, we accounted for 135 Jap planes. In addition, two enemy cargo ships were sunk and nine others damaged. We lost only six planes. Not one of our ships was sunk. These are official Navy pictures. Jap Navy didn't turn up, as usual, even though the enemy detected our approach well in advance. Navy Secretary Knox said this raid in the one on Truk proved our mastery of the Pacific.